Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Thank you for attending our memorial ceremony. My name is Deputy Chief Mitch Cunningham, and it is my honor and privilege to host this very special occasion. I want to thank everyone for coming here to honor our fallen heroes. I especially want to welcome those loved ones and friends of those who paid the ultimate sacrifice and thank them for being a part of our ceremony. May I ask everyone to stand for the presentation of colors. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Can I ask everyone to remain standing? And let me introduce our police chaplain, Sergeant Lisa Kittrell, for our invocation.
Thank you, Chief. If you would, let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father God, thank you for bringing all of us together here this morning. Lord, we just show love and honor to the family and the friends, Lord, who have given such a sacrifice for their fallen loved ones. And we're here, Lord, just to lift them up and thank you for their service. And just remember them and honor them this morning, God. And may this service, Lord, honor you and honor their memory. And I thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Let me introduce Chief Ralph Evangelist of the Wilmington Police Department for his remarks.
Good morning. I'd like to recognize some folks here with us today. Our Mayor Bill Saffo, Mayor Pro Tem Margaret Haynes, our City Manager Sterling Cheatham, Councilman Clifford Barnett Sr., Councilman Kevin O'Grady, Councilman Charlie Reibenbach is out there. From the county, I'd like to recognize our DA, Ben David, our County Manager, Chris Coudray, Assistant County Manager Tim Burgess, Vice Chairman Skip Watkins, Commissioner Rob Zappel. From some law enforcement agencies are here with us today. Chief Deputy Ken Sarvis from New Haven County Sheriff's Office, First Sergeant Matthew King, North Carolina State Highway Patrol, Mike Ditta, Superintendent of Department of Corrections. I'd also like to recognize some folks here from our fallen officers, some families. Deputy John W. Bell, Joel and Janet Larson, thank you for being here. Deputy William P. Starling, Mr. William P. Starling, and his daughter, Morgan Starling, thank you for being here. Officer Thomas Devon, Michael Barron, and Scott Forncannon, and I hope I got that right. Thank you all for being here. Officer Roy Carney, Gerald and Gladys Branch and Cheryl Branch, thank you. Officer William Jordan, Julie King, and First Sergeant Matthew King, thank you. And Officer Chris Williams, Eli Williams, thank you so much for being here. We appreciate you. I want to thank each of you being here this morning. You know, this is a important day for all of us. I'd also like to give a special welcome to the members of the North Carolina Department of Public Safety Division of Prisons, along with their superintendent, Mike Ditta, of the New Hanover Correctional Center here in Wilmington. They have joined us this year to remember their own. This week, millions of law enforcement officers, families, and friends across the nation will participate in memorial services just like this one, commemorating the lives and brave sacrifices made by our fallen brothers and sisters. Since the first known line of duty death in 1791, more than 21,000 U.S. law enforcement officers have made the ultimate sacrifice. Last year, 128 law enforcement officers were killed in a line of duty. This day, each year, is a special day. It reminds us that we're all human, and the work we do is dangerous. It reminds us of the bravery exhibited by officers nationwide and the willingness to boldly go into the face of danger and to risk their own lives for the betterment of mankind. May we never forget their sacrifices and the work they've accomplished. May we never forget their families and the fellow officers they left behind, and may we never forget their names. Again, thank you for coming today and honoring the brave men and women in law enforcement. Thank you.
Now let me introduce Assistant Chief Jim Verone.
Good morning. Good morning and welcome to this year's Law Enforcement Memorial Service. Thank you to all our guests, local leaders, law enforcement personnel, and most especially to the families of our law enforcement officers that have made the ultimate sacrifice. Thank you for being here. Today I want to focus on our families and their importance to the law enforcement community. What do we know about families? Well, families is where, as youngsters, we begin to form our own personal moral compasses and learn how to socialize. Family life can be tough at times, where we often fight with one another, most times out of love. But yet, it's this love that keeps families together. Family is family, and family will look out for the welfare of family, just as it should be. Parents educate their children in hopes of preparing them for adulthood. So no doubt then, the family plays a very important support role. So why speak of families on such a memorial day? There's an important parallel to be made with the law enforcement community. So when a new officer enters the service, he or she develops their own set of professional ethics, just as a child develops their own moral compass interacting with their family. Law enforcement agencies train their officers to prepare them for the future challenges and to enhance their professional abilities. And yes, we do occasionally bicker with one another, most times resulting in better outcomes for us, but also for the communities that we serve. Just like the family unit, there to provide their very important support, so does the law enforcement community, offering its support to its professionals. So what's the takeaway here? Well, the law enforcement community in the United States is made up of nearly 1 million members. A million. Out of 300 million Americans plus. It's its own family. It really is. It exists not only to serve and protect the community, but to support its members and their families, you. When that officer joins the ranks, his or her families become part of this extended family. The family of our law enforcement officers wear that badge too, and they wear it hard, sometimes too hard. The law enforcement community takes in that officer's family, treats them as such, family. We need to remember this and strive to enhance this relationship. We can, and we need to do better. So this is why we're here today at this memorial. Yes, we are here today to honor those that have laid down their life for others. We can't forget that. However, we're also here to honor and remember the families that have suffered the loss of a family member, killed in the line of duty. We're here to support you. And most importantly, not forget your sacrifices. You too have paid an enormous price which can never be repaid. Similarly, we honor the law enforcement officers, the law enforcement families that kiss their loved ones goodbye at the beginning of their shifts and no doubt who worry tirelessly until they return through the safety of their household. As of May the 7th, our nation has suffered 51 officers lost in the line of duty. That's nearly 6% higher than it was this time last year. Unfortunately, this number will increase. It will. The cause of righteousness and living in a free country all too many times comes at a high price. But make no mistake, the bonds that exist between family and the law enforcement community are unbreakable. They form one family, and a family that will not forget about the sacrifices of the past, the present, and those that will come in the future. Today we honor the families and we thank you. We thank you. We can't thank you enough. We thank you for allowing your family members to be part of a greater cause, a righteous cause, law enforcement and service to the community. So I say this to the families, the law enforcement community, your extended family, honors you not just today, but every day. Every day. May God bless law enforcement officers everywhere, and may He keep them in His safety. May God bless the families of slain law enforcement officers and continue to offer His solace. May God watch over the families of law enforcement everywhere. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief. Let me now introduce New Hanover County Chief Deputy Ken Sarnes.
Thank you and good morning. I want to thank Chief Evangelist and Assistant Chief Jim Barone, the Wilmington Police Department. For every year they take the opportunity to have a service that is very special to each and every one of us, especially to the families that are gathered here today as lost ones. This is the time we take every year to honor and remember those that have made the ultimate sacrifice by protecting our community. They served. As I was thinking of this service today, I thought about the last year service that we were gathered here. Many of you were gathered here. And as I look at the three words, and I look at the names that are on this memorial, and I look at the three words, I can't think of any three words that better display what each and every individual on that wall believed in, and it is a good example. And those three words are honor, duty, and sacrifice. Each and every one of us believe in honor, duty, and sacrifice that wear the badge. And these individuals that are on this wall today certainly did believe in that. I truly believe that the men and women that wear the badge have been called to do so. I believe it is a calling. It is a higher calling. I truly believe that. I believe it's more than just a job. It is a noble calling. It is a calling where we stand in the gap between the evil in this world and the good in this world. I want to personally thank each and every law enforcement that works in this community, that has the courage to put that badge and that uniform on every day, not knowing if they'll come back like they left that morning or that evening. It takes courage. And I just want to say I appreciate that courage that each and every one of you display. And I want to thank, special thank you, as it's already been said, the families that are gathered here. We owe you a humble gratitude and indebted to you. And we always will. One of the things I would like to encourage each and every one of us to do, and I try to do it often, if not on a daily basis, and ask that the good Lord place a hedge of protection around each and every one of us that go out and serve this community. And I ask that each and every person that's here today, if you haven't been doing that, I ask that you do that. Pray for that hedge of protection. Chief talked about 128 people last year, Chief Evangelist did, that lost their lives in their serving their community. Chief Verone talked about 51 just this year. I'm going to tell you another figure. That figure is since last May, there have been 100, till last May when we had this service, to this service today, we've had 137 give their life. Five of those were in North Carolina alone. Five of those. I would like to end with a scripture I find in John 15:13, where it says, "Greater love have no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends." May God bless you all.
Let me introduce Mayor Bill Saffo of our great city.
I'd also like to recognize County Commissioner Jonathan Barfield that is also here, and also Council Member Paul Lawler is also here in the back, and Charlie Rivenbach. Charlie, good to have you folks here. Wilmington is a great city, it's a great place, but we couldn't have the great city that we have without the men and the women of law enforcement that protect us and make certain that people abide by the law. And we appreciate your public service to our community and to our state and to our nation. But the people that have given the ultimate sacrifice, the people that are here on this wall, we cannot thank the families, we cannot thank these people right here, right now, but what they gave to this community over the years, something that we cannot repay. But we hope and pray that God rest their souls and that their memories are always eternal in our hearts and in our minds and in this city's heart and mind. So thank you, God bless you, and God bless this great memorial service that we have here today. Thank you very much.
Let me introduce New Hanover County Commissioner, New Hanover County Manager, Chris Coudret.
Good morning. First, I want you to know it is a personal honor and privilege to be here with all of you this morning. Thank you to the New Hanover County Sheriff's Office, the Wilmington Police Department, and our many other law enforcement agencies that are here with us, and thank you for what you do day in and day out. And we know what you do. You run into danger while most of us run away. You help fight the opioid epidemic on our streets every day. You save lives. You show compassion to those that you protect. And you make our neighborhoods safer. New Hanover County and the Board of Commissioners are committed to ensuring superior public safety across our entire community. It's what our citizens deserve, and it is what your county promises you. That promise, that value proposition, so to speak, is to make our community safe, healthy, and secure. Thank you to Commissioners Barfield, Watkins, and Zappel, who are with us this morning, for holding all of us accountable to providing and delivering on that proposition. The county cannot keep its promise without you, without supporting you and investing in you. And it certainly cannot keep its promise if we don't all come together and join in celebration and recognition for the sacrifice that so many of you make day in and day out to keep our community safe and secure. And it's not lost on me why we are here together this morning. To the families, we are forever indebted to your public servants and ours who have lost their lives fulfilling the most important role of ensuring our community's safety and security. And they did it as the law enforcement professionals they wanted to be and that they are still recognized as today. The honor and value they brought to our community in their pursuit of justice, the lives that they touched, and the safety and security they provided are remembered today and always. As law enforcement officers, you are called to serve. We know that you face difficult situations every day. Today, and tomorrow and in the future, I want you to know that everybody in this community, everybody sitting here, we support you, we appreciate you, and we thank you for taking on this most serious responsibility. God bless.
Let me introduce Mr. Skip Watkins of the new Hanover County Commission.
So many great words have been spoken today. I'm just going to share something personal with you. Every morning I get up, I pray for our men and women in uniform. Military, law enforcement, first responders, you're in the list every day. Thank you for what you do. May God keep you and hold you, and go home safely. God bless.
And let me introduce our district attorney, Ben David.
Good morning. Every time this year, just as the final azaleas fall to the ground, we gather in this space to remember our fallen heroes. On behalf of the 275,000 people I represent in the 5th District, on behalf of all the judges, the 43 men and women of the District Attorney's Office, I want to remind this community that the more than 1,000 officers who I'm so privileged to advise in 20 different police agencies here in New Hanover and Pender County, they are the heroes. And we should remember that each and every day, not just in early May, but each and every day. You know, when I was a little boy, my grandfather taught me something about heroism. He was part of the greatest generation, the one that had returned home from World War II and did more by the age of 25 than most of us will do in a lifetime. To me, he was a hero. But that's not what he considered himself. And as I look out among these amazing officers right now, I constantly try to find ways to praise your bravery and your kindness. We have Service Above Self Awards, for instance, every year just at our Rotary Club to recognize the incredible sacrifices you make on a daily basis. But you keep deflecting that. You keep saying, I'm not worthy of this award. And that's exactly what my grandfather said. He said, you know, there's a difference between Veterans Day and Memorial Day. Said what so many in his generation said. All gave some, but some gave all. Ben, the real heroes are still back on that beach at Normandy, 10,000 in the cemetery that's called the American Cemetery. They're at the bottom of Guadalcanal or at some of these other places that we had battles. Those were the heroes. I just did my job. And I keep hearing that from the men and women who I serve among every day in the courts. And so today we are recognizing those some who gave all, those who are the true heroes that really did their duty with great honor and pay the ultimate sacrifice for the rest of us. I want to say something about prayer because, like so many of you, I pray for law enforcement as well. You know, it was 2 years ago that this country was in the grips of a great us against them debate. Didn't it seem like that? Where officers were not only killed in high-speed pursuits and in calls to domestic violence, but were actually being targeted because of their badge, because of their status. Do you remember those times down in Dallas and in Louisiana and other places? And we were not immune to that. And at the height of that tension, I came to this service and actually saw something remarkable. And as the media filmed everybody here at the front, I saw towards the back something going on that I wanted to share with all of you. There were a group of school children, teenagers, and middle school's a tough time. I know I have two of them myself. They had all come to this gate from DC Virgo to watch what we were doing. There wasn't a coach, there wasn't a teacher in sight. And I thought to myself, oh, I hope this goes well, because I know this is a solemn proceeding and there's going to be a moment where we call for silence. And if one of them wanted to be disruptive, they could be. And as we had a prayer for law enforcement, I looked back and instead of seeing anybody catcalling or being out of line, I saw every one of their heads bowed, praying for you. Now, these are young men and women who know all too well the crime that exists in our community. Many of them have had older brothers and sisters and cousins and parents meet many of you in your day job, even be incarcerated, and they were praying for you. I want you to know that the community I represent loves and honors each and every one of you, and these people on this wall in particular. Some of us are privileged enough to know them by name and actually remember their funerals, or get to talk to them in a courtroom, or for them in a courtroom, as I did. But for those of you who didn't know, remember what a hero looks like. It's on this wall, and it's out there on that street right now. And so on behalf of everybody who I represent, and particularly to the families, I want to say God bless each and every one of you. Thank you all for your service, and may we never forget the incredible sacrifice of the men and women of law enforcement. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. David. At this time, I'll ask Chief Evangelist, Chief Deputy Sarvis, to present the memorial wreath. Let me ask Chief Deputy Sarvis to begin reading of the fallen deputies.
Deputy John W. Bell, end of watch, March 31st, 1926. Deputy William P. Starling, end of watch,
Officer Thomas Devon, end of watch, August 5th, 1865. Officer William F. Craig. End of watch, September 23rd, 1918. Officer Leon George, end of watch, July 29th, 1924. Officer Roy J. Carney, end of watch, April 1st, 1937. Officer David Hall, end of watch, November 7th, 1949. Officer William C. Jordan, end of watch, June 11th, 1950. Officer Clarence A. Davis, end of watch, June 24th, 1971. Officer James W. Nunley, Sr., end of watch, April 4th, 1978. Officer Christopher F. Williams, end of watch, June 16, 2006. Officer Richard J. Matthews, end of watch, February 18, 2009.
Let me introduce Superintendent Mike Ditta from the Department of Public Safety, Division of Prisons, for the reading of the names.
Thank you. Goldsboro Police Major Ray Memlar Jr., end of watch, February 16, 2017. Bertie Correctional Sergeant Megan Callahan, end of watch, April 26, 2017. Pasquotank Correctional Officer Justin Smith, end of watch, October 12th, 2017. Pasquotank Enterprise Manager Veronica Darden, end of watch, October 12th, 2017. Pasquotank Correctional Officer Wendy Shannon, end of watch, October 30th, 2017. Pasquotank Maintenance Engineer Jeffrey Howe, end of watch, November 2nd, 2017. all other officers killed or disabled in the line of duty across the United States.
I'd like to ask everybody to rise and request Chaplain Sergeant Kittrell to deliver the benediction.
Thank you. Again, I would like to thank and appreciate with appreciation for the families to be here, the heroes that died and passed on, your family and friends, also the names on that wall and all over this great country. I'd also like to just recognize our retired officers who have given so many years in this job honorably and are here with us today. I'd like to just give a thank you and honor them as well. If we bow our heads now, please. Father God, thank you for this service. I thank each and every person that showed up. Pray a blessing for these family and friends touched, dear God, by this tragedy. But they're heroes now, Lord. Their loved ones are heroes and always will be. Lord, I pray for each and every one of us here, especially the ones that carry this badge. And Lord, that you would surround us and protect us, Lord, that we would be able to go out there and help and heal. And you would watch us, Lord, while we're doing that in our job. Lord, for our leaders, the people in this department, every person, Lord, and every agency, Lord, that runs that department from top to bottom. Lord, I pray a special blessing on them. And Lord, each and every one of us out here that have came and showed up, Lord, that you would strengthen us, Lord, help us with issues that we have, Lord, and a blessing and covering, Lord, for all of us. And I thank you so much, Lord, for this day. And in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Please remain standing for the retirement of colors.